question is, why is CS, women that did CS, being stigmatized, especially if these ones are now into ministry? Oh. So people feel like, ladies feel like, my pastor's wife, she did CS. Once I carry my head like this, I beg, I'm not even going to go. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Hi, I'm Christina Kelvin. If you're new here, I say thank you so very much for stopping by. And if you've been watching my video this way and you have not subscribed, well, please do well to subscribe and press the bell beside it so that you get notified each time I drop a video. So as you can see, today I have a guest in the house. Yeah. I don't know if I'm to say I'm the guest or she's the guest. Anyways.
Yeah.
Okay, so with me is Pastor Mrs. Adeyemi. Pastor Mrs. Eniola Adeyemi, popularly known as Sister Henny. You know, marriage gifted her to me. She's one of those wonderful people that I've met through my husband, and I'm grateful for the gift of her. She's a mother to so many. Ha! She has plenty daughters and sons. My husband is one of the sons, all right? And I'm one of the daughters. But you know, I don't know my number. Anyways, we move. Number one. Everybody, you can see, oh. She said I'm number one. Oh, okay. I hope some people will not come for my head.
I have many number one.
Yeah, you see, she has many number one.
We are one before God.
Kosiwala. I'll take it as that, all right? Yeah. Okay, so she's into the medical profession. You know, she's a nurse. And at the same time, she is a ministry person. She's into ministry. She's married to a pastor. And she herself, she's a pastor. She's blessed with two wonderful kids at the moment. You know, we never can tell. Anything can happen. Azia. So, help me welcome Mama Henny into the house. Welcome, Ma.
Thank you for having me here. It's a great pleasure to be on your YouTube channel.
Thank you so very much for accepting. Hey, if you know how, if you know the magnitude of who she is, you will know that it's a privilege.
Have you?
To have her to have her here. Actually, you know, she's a woman that she's down to earth, very, very accessible. And at the same time, she's so full of wisdom. Number one thing I think I love so much about her, well, let me tell her now, today, is the fact that she's very, very accessible. You know, she didn't see herself as, I'm up there. No, everybody's just free with her. And that I so much love about her. She's so much full of wisdom. I mean, only wise girl. She's full of wisdom. No hyping here. You trust the girl. I won't hype anything. She's full of wisdom, and I feel like today there's this question that has always been jarring. That I've always been thinking about, especially lately. I've seen it around me. I've heard it. I've heard people talk about it. And I'm like, I know she's capable and well grounded. Okay. So actually, do justice to that question. And the question is, why is CS, women that did CS, being stigmatized, especially if these ones are now into ministry? Oh. So people feel like, ladies feel like, my pastor's wife, she did CS. Once I carry my head like this, I beg you, I'm not even going to go close to her. Because they feel like, well, the pastor's wife might actually not be passing that message. She might not be saying it. But people feel like, what would be your advice if that is actually what you experience? Oh. If what the person did, if what the woman did is have a CS for all her children, they feel like, I'm not safe with this woman. She will advise, she will not give any other advice and say CS is the best. Then that's a side of it. Why is it actually being stigmatized?
Okay. Let me quickly say this, that CS is not an attack, and it is not a crisis thrown at you from the kingdom of hell. CS is a normal procedure And anybody can be sexual. Either you are a pastor's wife or you are not. Okay? And let me also say this to every mom or to every aspiring mom, that the first thing that makes you a real mom is your ability to decide the means of having your baby. Like if you're having your baby by vagina or by section, we have what we call elective CX and what we call emergency CS. Now, emergency CS is a situation whereby a woman is already in labor. She's already in labor, or and maybe she's having prolonged labor, or the labor is not making progress, or something just happens suddenly. Maybe there is fetal distress, maybe the situation whereby the baby is not breathing very well again. So your gynecologist can decide for you at that time that, woman, we need to take you through a cesarean section. And this situation can actually happen to anybody, irrespective of who you are. Either you are a pastor's wife, either you are a woman in ministry, or you are a woman in, or you are a career woman. So don't let anybody stigmatize you. I understand the African concept of stigmatizing people. We stigmatize everything stigmatizable. If there's an English like that. Anything that we can stigmatize is what we stigmatize. It is really an issue of concern. Because I don't see the reason why you would say, because your pastor's wife has a baby through cesarean section, you cannot go to her for counsel. She's not the one to decide if you should have your baby through a cesarean section or through a vaginal delivery. It should be your own decision, or it should be a decision between you and your doctor. Do you understand? If you don't have medical issues like hypertension, like cephalopelvic disproportion, maybe the situation whereby the pelvic is smaller for the baby
to pass through.
You understand? If there are no situations like that, or gestational diabetics, somebody who have diabetes, a mother who has HIV, you don't expect such mother to go through vaginal delivery. Because it is important you consider the health of the baby
and the mother.
And there is no point having a mom and the child is gone, or especially where you have the baby and the mother is gone. So we have so many issues that could suggest that a woman should go through a C-section. And please, for goodness sake, don't stigmatize anybody. It is evil. In short, the evil of stigmatizing is more than the assumption to think that CS is an attack. It is not an attack from anywhere. It is a normal procedure. It's just like you have appendix now. Somebody, they now operated you and remove your appendix. You now say, so if stomach is paining, everybody will tell you, or your pastor will now tell you that it's appendix, so that's how my stomach pain started. You know, we have so many misconceptions, and I think we need to drop them. It's high time we need to, especially in Africa. It's high time you need to drop them. Please and please, take this from me, that cesarean section is not a stigma. It is not an attack. It does not remove anything from your value as a woman is intact. Having your baby through cesarean section does not change the fact that you are a woman. You are still a woman, able woman, and a champion woman at that.
I love that. Wow, that's such a beautiful one. You know, she said something very profound that I actually need to re-echo. She said, your number one ability, what makes you a mom, is your number one ability to choose how
to have your
you
baby.
Want to have your baby, be it through cesarean section or
vagina.
Through which any other means you can think of. You know, let me tell you something. Actually, while I was actually pregnant, she walked through that phase with me. She and one other mama of mine that will soon come, I mean very very soon, she will still be on this channel, and I don't want to say what actually, I don't let me go too deep, but these two people, actually her and Pastor Mrs. Tony Arewale, these two people walked through with me on my pregnancy journey, and mama, should I say it?
Let's keep it.
We should keep it. She said we should keep it, you know. So please, it's high time we stop stigmatizing those that have stigmatization generally is
it's evil.
Is, you see, she said
it's an evil thing to stigmatize.
It's evil.
It can be anybody.
It can exactly. You see, it can be held.
And
it can
CS, for crying out. I don't know where that idea come from.
Okay.
I don't know who pitted that idea that if you have a CS, you're not a complete mom.
Mm.
It is, I think it is an insult on God.
Mm.
For anyone to stigmatize a means of a baby coming into the world.
Mm.
Because even people who have vaginal delivery, somebody actually assisted them.
Yeah.
There's a midwife in your room.
Mm-hmm.
The baby didn't come out on its own. You were assisted. And we have some people that they will still have to cut them.
Yeah.
You understand? The process of cutting you is also a process of assisting you to have your baby. So just like somebody now telling you that because they cut you during your vaginal delivery, you're not able. You're not an able woman. You're not a complete mom.
Mm.
Do you understand how painful it is for a woman to go through
9 months
journey and somebody now tell you that, madam, due to this condition, okay, let me quickly say this. I personally, I don't like labor.
Mm.
I don't even like vagina delivery. Not for two reasons. Because my tolerance level to pain is zero.
Mm.
I can't bear pain. I can't imagine myself going through that pain. I actually read this in a book. And when you look at the systemic of labor, when you read at the mechanism of labor, fear naturally can grip anyone. And for somebody like me, I have decided long ago, ever before I got married, that I'm not going to have any baby by vagina. So it's a decision. So if you like, stigmatize it. It's your cup of tea. But at least I am fine. I have my able children. That is the most important. That is the joy of motherhood.
Yeah.
You are beautiful. Your baby are growing. And you are seeing them. You are looking. So this seed actually come out from me. And you imagine that somebody was cut. She went through that pain. And you have the God to say, because she's a spiritual woman, so she should not have cesarean section.
Or because of that, she can't give an advice. She
cannot advise you. Listen to me. It is not an advice that will decide if you should have your baby through cesarean section.
Or vagina.
If you want it, go and meet your gynecologist. Madam, sir, I want my baby through
as section. As she has said, she had CS.
I had
CS. And she stood with me and while I was pregnant.
I will always tell as many people as
I didn't have CS, actually.
Push your baby out. And if for any reasons your doctor suggests to you
CS.
To have your baby two sections, don't make a slight delay. Go ahead. It is not, it doesn't depend that God is not on your side. I think that is where the concept comes from, that once you have a baby two C-section, God is not on your side. Let me tell you, in short, God is more on our side.
Mm.
Because he actually gave that wisdom to those people to section you. And if God is not on your side, you won't come back alive. Do you get it?
Thank you so very much for that wisdom. I think it's high time, especially for us, especially those are always thinking that, the pastor's wife, she did CS, I beg you. It's a no for me. It's high time we stopped, all right? Whichever means you use in having your baby, just know that that is the perfect means God wants
for you
to have it.
That's it.
Just know that that is the perfect means that God wants you to have it. Thank you so very much for coming and, you know, for dishing out that wisdom, Mama. I'm so much blessed by it. I've learned two things. Whichever way you choose to have your baby, is your number one ability to as a mother. And of course, stigmatization is actually evil. All right, so thank you so very much for